Tihomir, can you maybe explain the concept of DSEM to me?
We in the version Mplus 8, we actually started with this DSEM model,
yeah,
where it's everything is very structural and you have a dependent variable, mm-hmm, that you're interested in, and you can regress that dependent variable on some predictors here, yeah, xt at time t, and some and basically the same variable from the previous period.
So that's t minus one.
Yeah. And so we released this model, and that fits quite well in the structural equation modeling framework very well. The problem is that people have been having a hard time interpreting these coefficients in practical terms, and they want to know the effect of these covariates, how they affect the dependent variables. The problem is that these covariates actually would enter the equations also from the previous time point here,
yep,
and they will have a combined effect that's a little bit hard to interpret.
Yep.
So we've been actually starting to get interested in these residual DSEM models that
are...
Yeah, the residual DSEM models that are this model right here.
Mm-hmm.
And with this model, the effect of the covariates is separate from the autoregressive version of the equation. So
yep,
this xt, this prediction equation here, affects directly the xt, and the interpretation of the coefficients is the standard regression model. So it's actually easier to interpret than the DSEM model.
Mm-hmm.
The problem with this residual DSEM model, though, is that in the standard classical methodology, they've used kind of a simple methods to actually estimate it, but in a very structural and general framework,
mm-hmm,
the actual computation of this model is much harder than this model. It's because if you try to estimate these coefficients alpha and beta,
yeah,
you have to basically express the epsilons here and substitute them in here,
yep,
which basically gets you to this equation right here.
Right.
And if you expand this equation, you see that the dependent variable yt now is regressed on not just xt, but also has this effect from the previous
yep,
period of xt.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And so now you have to estimate, in order to estimate now, for example, coefficient beta,
mm-hmm,
it's more complex because it's not just a standard random coefficient,
yep,
that you can estimate as in here, just one coefficient in one place. Now you can see that the beta coefficient actually appears in two places,
yep,
and so does the alpha actually. I think I missed
the
alpha
here. And you also got two
here.
Estimates for the beta, Sam, two different estimates.
Well, no, there's supposed to be one estimate. So that's okay. The thing is that we want to actually combine all the information so
yep,
you get just the pure posterior distribution of beta.
Mm-hmm.
And actually there's minus alpha here, minus r times alpha. So the alpha also appears on two places.
Yep.
And basically, what happens here, if you can imagine this in a multivariate form, this actually is matrix multiplication.
Yeah.
And so the coefficients actually get spread out quite a bit everywhere,
yeah,
in the equation. And especially if you have a lag two or more, you know, then you get a much bigger sequence,
yeah, yeah,
and the beta coefficients are absolutely everywhere. So
yeah,
I came up with a little solution that is based on linear restrictions.
Okay.
And so we basically have a way to estimate this. Yeah, you estimate two separate coefficients here,
yeah,
for these two,
mm-hmm,
and then you impose, in addition to that, the restriction that it's visible here that this coefficient is just r times beta.
Yeah, yeah,
and
yeah,
so using this, restriction equation and the fact that it's a linear restriction equation through some first and second order derivatives,
mm-hmm,
that come out quite nice, it is possible to just get the posterior distribution of this, you know, interpret this as a beta 1 and this as a beta 2.
Yep.
And then from the posterior distribution of beta 1 and beta 2, in addition to that, impose the additional constraint of these guys to get the final distribution for beta. So it's
a
little
smart
bit
trick, right?
Yeah, it's a little more complicated than this other stuff. So, and that's actually implemented now in this version that is a beta version of the next software package
okay,
that we're preparing. So it's already available in certain cases, and I'm going to present some simulations later about this. So
thank you so much, Tihomir.
Yeah.
This is great.
Yeah.
Thanks.
Thanks, Franz.